tonight on TV One Life.
Six out of ten.
Hey, I'm Corbin, here with five of my closest enemies. They're gonna push me down these stairs. It's what we like to call downhill wagon moguls. Let's go!
Stop! This is extremely safe stunt!
That's right, we got more pads, we got a couple more bags of styrofoam, we got the ambulance on their way, and we're ready to do this. Those steps didn't look dangerous enough, so here we go on these.
That didn't work.
Yeah.
Try again.
Alright, Michael, 911, you alright?
Yeah, I was a little upset that my wagon didn't come all the way down with me, but it turned out all right. And that is how the cookie crumbles.
All I have to say is keep Josh away from those beans.
If you like food at your house, then don't invite Becky over. She'll eat it all.
My parents think that Nick is a mess.
Hey, I'm Sean Parker with the One Life crew, and this week we had blocks and we were making, I guess, what you'd call abstract art.
It was definitely abstract.
I don't think I'd call it art, though.
No,
not so much.
You be the judge.
The student's assignment this week is to get strangers to recreate what they've seen in a photo.
So we got some huge boxes, this really cool picture, and we're gonna see just how good people's memories are. So I'm gonna let you guys look at this picture for 30 seconds, and then I'm gonna give you 2 minutes to build it.
Okay.
Think
okay.
You can do it?
Maybe. Let's do it.
All right, here we go.
Okay. Green to the left, green, trash can.
Go for it, knock it out. So what's the grade you're going to give yourself?
B minus.
B minus.
Yeah. B minus, that's it? What are some options? Maybe while you're building it, something you could have done or asked for, or maybe right when I showed you the picture, something you could have done.
We could have put out our cell phone and took a picture of it.
See?
That's what we could have done.
Yeah.
Now how would that have helped?
Because then we would have had the picture the whole time.
We would have had the picture the whole time.
Yeah.
You know, those couple guys want to take a picture of our picture. And I think that's a really good idea. When I read the Bible, it really gives me a better picture of what God has for me.
Get to it.
Oh my gosh. Whoops. Ta-da!
What do you think? What kind of grade would you give yourself? Come on,
C
here's
minus.
The answer. Let's say I can't give you the picture.
Okay.
What could you have done?
You can tell me where to put the stuff while you hold the picture.
Okay, so you could ask me for some help.
Yeah.
All right. Why would I be able to help you more than you without the picture?
Because I can't remember as good as you looking at it.
Okay. It was my idea for you to build this, so that makes sense.
Wow, those sure were some ugly... What are they?
Boxes?
I don't even know. No one even came close to getting what the picture had on it.
No, they definitely were struggling with it.
Some people did okay, but I think in general, people were probably grading themselves a little higher than they should have been. But I think it's a tough situation, because I only gave them like 30 seconds to look at the picture, and now they've got to recreate something that doesn't look like anything else. Yeah. It's very random, you know. They're totally going into a blind. But they struggled with it, having not been able to look at the picture. And I think it's like trying to go through life without direction or without having God's vision. And that really makes it impossible to really fulfill God's plans for our life.
Yeah. Don't you think that if they maybe would have been able to look at that picture a couple more times? I know a few of them thought about maybe taking pictures of it with their cell phone. Don't you think that could have helped, though?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the more you see a picture, the easier it is to remember it and the better you could recreate it.
Yeah, I think we need to look at the picture that God has for us, and not maybe just one time, but kind of keep it in the forefront of our mind, you know, maybe write it down in a place that we'll look at it more often. I think we'll probably head in that direction a little bit more successfully.
I think it's really important to get a vision from God in our life, and it makes it a lot easier when we don't have preset plans that we want to happen. And, you know, God just wants us to be a clean slate. I got hired on the border right when I got out of college, and one of the things that the manager loved about me was that I'd never waited tables before, and so that way he could train me and mold me into that perfect server that he wanted me to be. And the same is true with God. You know, he wants us to be a clean slate before him so that he can shape us and mold us into the person that he wants us to be.
Yeah, it's definitely easy when God gives you a vision for your life. It was at a missions conference about 7 years ago that God gave me a vision for my life. For the future, he called me into the missions field to Ecuador, and since then I've been there 5 times, and that's where I'm pursuing my life, is in that direction.
Hey, we're Firefly.
And TV One Life tastes better than fried ice cream.
Hi, Andy. Hi, Randy. How are you? Happy as Yankee Doodle Dandy. And you?
Oh, I'm living life in Neverland. Deep. You know, that lawnmower almost put an end to our incredible adventure.
Yeah, it's a good thing we're short, or else we'd be gone.
Yeah, we sure tried to run, but there wasn't much we could do. Okay, if we're going to catch a giant bug, we need to get another body.
All right, let's shake a leg.
Okay, let's go.
Well, that wasn't so bad. Actually, it was. Maybe next time we could use the stairs?
Okay, now in order to avoid the pitfalls of the past, this time, we really need to stay low and walk in the shadows.
Well, this has gone rather smoothly so far.
Yeah, since they put the dog in the backyard, things haven't been nearly so rough.
Oh, get it off me! Get it off me!
Well, if you would just stop moving, I could swat it off. Whoa, that thing is huge!
No kidding, Crocodile Randy.
Well, why don't you stop, drop, and roll? You could smush it.
Oh, it's okay. It's gone.
That was a close one. You are starting to bug out.
Whoa, did you see that? That bug just spontaneously combusted before our eyes. Randy, do you have any SPF 45? It's getting really hot out here.
No, it's not hot. You're on fire!
What do I do? What do I do?
Stop, drop, and roll. Stop, drop, and roll.
That's what you said last time. Help!
Ah, look what you've done now. We're both on fire.
That was too hot. Oh, give me some water. Here's water. Hurry. Oh, we gotta put this out. Sorry, Randy.
It's okay. You were just really fired up.
Yeah, I was da bomb.
Yeah, you were really cooking.
It was fun. I think we should do it some more.
Does your life smell? Then spruce it up with internship. Internship is 1 year of travel, ministry, discipleship, world missions, challenges, motivation, transformation, adventure, and change. But wait, there's more. Internship is also TV, music, retreats, drama, events, prayer, friends, and incredible experiences that will launch you into your destiny. Don't you feel better now? Internship.
Bye, One Life.
Hey, this is Sean Park here with Fireflight, and they're getting ready to rock it out this evening.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Of course. So the first question that we have for you is, who in your band falls for the most pranks?
Oh, that's got to be Fee.
Yeah.
Yeah, our drummer is really easy to mess with. In fact, he's the primary gas pumper. In the band, and
that's a job description.
That is a job description: drummer, gas pumper. And he, every time he walks in front of the RV, almost we honk the horn, and he jumps. And he'll even be watching us, like without the corner of his eye, walking in front. We'll go boom, and he'll go, and then he'll crack himself up.
So we're talking about vision on this episode. What role has a God-given vision or dream played in your lives, personally, or maybe in the band?
Well, we've been a pretty vision-empowered band from the very beginning. Our other guitarist, Glenn, he had been in several bands growing up, and none of them had worked out, and he just pretty much given up on it. But he felt like God spoke to him and said, you just need to give it one more try. And that's what prompted him to start looking for people to be in his band. And before long, we were all together, and we hadn't been doing it very long when I was personally having a Bible study, doing devotional, and I felt like God told me that he was going to take our band out to the stage of the world to share his message of his love. And that was about 8 years ago. And it took about 5 years before we were able to start doing this full time. And then within the last year, God used our music on primetime television on NBC, and people all over were able to listen to it. And it was amazing that after all that time and all that hard work and all the time when we felt like nothing was happening and we weren't moving forward, God really brought us through that. And I think it's really been those visions that have helped to keep us strong.
All right, boys and girls, grandmas and grandpas, germs and gerbils, it's time for our speed round. Guys, put your hands on your buzzers. Sound in when you feel like you have the correct answer to this question. Who loses the most stuff?
I think you buzz in first.
Don.
It's true.
Don. Okay. Blank makes me cry.
My wife. Oh. I'm just kidding. Sorry.
Oh, wait.
You can buzz in on that one.
The news. The news makes me cry.
The news makes me cry.
Yeah.
Sorry, that question didn't count. You didn't buzz in.
Oh my gosh. You were.
I didn't get the point for that one.
Okay, that's right. You get one more shot here. Describe your band as a dance move.
The Running Man.
The Running Man. I was gonna say that.
Yes.
In 5 words, summarize this.
Something that wasted my time.
What are we summarizing?
Exactly.
We're this?
Exactly. That pause is what wasted my time.
Oh, yeah.
You could summarize TV One Life.
I'm kidding.
Well, this has been Fireflight. To find out more about them, go to tvonelife.com. Thanks, guys, for coming on.
No problem.
If you guys enjoy watching this TV show, TV One Life, then you really want to bring one of these events to your city. We get into the presence of God, and we take everybody there with us.
You gotta be here!
It's really cool to see all those people come down front and answer the altar call. I just love going out there and sharing the love that Jesus has put on the inside of me with other people.
Got it?
You got more time.
All right.
Don't jip yourself. Okay, that's it. What do you think?
I don't think I remembered it well. Let's say you're grading it. I don't think I would have passed. So, what could you have done to, like, make this better?
I think maybe I could have studied the picture longer.
I think I would have a hard time remembering that, too. Too many blocks and shapes for my memory.
So, how'd you grade yourself? What do you think?
80.
I don't know. Does it help to maybe write things down, or if you have plans for your life or goals or things you want to go after, what are some things you can do to kind of make sure that you really get where you're trying to get to?
I actually have lists and then steps that go with those lists to help me towards what goal I'm going to, and I cross them off.
Okay.
So.
Okay, well that's real good. Does it work?
It works a lot. It helps me get my things that I need done. Small list and big list, lifetime and short goals.
Okay. Would it help to maybe share some of that information with a friend or somebody so that...
Accountability partners. Mm-hmm. I have one. She's amazing.
So how does that help? What does that do for you?
I bounce off the things I'm doing, tell her what's been going on, and she reminds me of the different goals, the different things I'm supposed to be doing.
I figured that would be a little easier than it was. But then again, I had looked at the picture for quite a while. I think it's like that with God's word. The more I look at it, the easier it is to do what he wants.
What do you think? How'd you rate yourself?
6 out of 10.
Would it be easier to make the decision if you knew kind of where you're supposed to be in 10 years?
Yeah, I think it would. Like, if you knew what was going to happen, you know, of course, you know, you think, well, if I know I'm going to do that, then I should move here. I should take this job. I should study this. Mm-hmm. Should try harder in this. Maybe not worry so much about this.
I think that girl came the closest to getting it right. And I think the reason why is she seems to really understand the importance of remembering things. And she knows her limitations and was telling me about the way she writes things down. She makes lists about everything to make sure she doesn't forget.
And I really liked how she talked about she also had accountability and people watching out for her to help her make sure that she achieved the things that she wanted to achieve.
Yeah, I'm definitely stubborn in that way. I don't usually write things down, therefore I don't remember them.
You know, I have a really bad memory too, and so I have to write things down, whether, you know, it's something as simple as taking out the trash, or I need to wash my dog on this day, and if
or
I
maybe,
can't...
Maybe wash your clothes, or...
Yeah, I mean, well, they can't smell like out there, just you guys.
Thank goodness.
But I mean, if I can't even remember the simple things without writing them down, how can I ever expect to remember what God is telling me without writing it down?
That's why I think the Bible says that when we get the vision that we're supposed to write it down so that we can read it and so that we can run with that vision. And when we do that, we'll have a plan for our life.
I think that's the key, having a plan. You know, lots of people have dreams or things that they want to fulfill in God through their life, but they don't know how to practically implement them. And I think it's important to write them down and be heading in the right direction, because basically, a vision is like having a dream with deadlines. You've got to figure out a way that you can work towards that goal.
So what you're saying is when God gives you a vision, you need to maybe write it down and schedule, you know, when I'm going to do these things and how I'm going to get these things done. And then also maybe have some friends or some other people help hold you accountable to those things, right?
Yeah, because chances are the vision isn't something simple. You know, it's usually going to be a big picture. And
it probably isn't going to be achieved in one simple step, yeah. So there's going to be a lot of different parts to get there.
I've done it! I've created the perfect plan to take over the world! Quasi-Brain, come here.
Is Quasi-Brain on?
Whatever, just get over here.
Oh, what is it, Master? What is your plan to take over the world?
I've created a formula that will make people act and respond like chickens.
Oh, that is so foul!
Shut up! My plan is to taint the world's water supply with this potion. And then for those who do not drink water any longer, I will put it in the world's supply of energy drinks. Then this formula will make them turn into chickens. Chickens that I can control. And then I will rule the world.
You will be at the top of the pecking order. Get it? Chickens pecking, pecking?
Shut up, Foggy Brain.
Master. Why did the chicken cross the road?
I don't know. Why?
Because you said so.
That was a good one. Now, before we proceed, we must test this potion on this guinea pig.
But Master, I thought we were making chickens.
We are. Now, inject this into this man, Quaggy Brain.
Bottoms up!
It worked! It worked! I've done it! I will now rule the world!
Get off! Get off! Master! He's not listening!
Stop it, little chicken! Leave him alone! You must obey me! I'm your master!
Master! I don't think it's working! Chickens won't listen to you!
Blast it! You're right, Half-Brain. We must move to Plan B.
Plan B?
Yes, Plan B is the Spellbinder 2000X. It will send subliminal messages to all the people watching Oprah. And it will hypnotize them, making them believe that I rule the world.
But not everyone watches Oprah!
Well, then I'll put it on The View.
The what?
It's like Oprah, except four women talk about themselves instead of just one.
Are you sure the whole world watches that?
No. So we must move on to Plan C.
Plan C?
Yes, Plan C. I will, create a device in which people type with their thumbs on miniature keyboards in new languages. And they will be so busy typing those small buttons that they will not know that I rule the world.
But Master, it's already been done. It's called a cell phone. LOL, LOL.
How dare they steal my idea? I've had enough. I'm going to bed, Queasy Brain.
But Master, what will we do tomorrow?
The same thing we do every day. Try to take over the world.
Girl! Get away! Get away! Stupid chicken! Stupid chicken!
Picture yourself in a foreign country, changing lives. Come on!
My world
now.
It's really amazing how God can pull stuff out of you that you never even knew was inside of you.
If I had to describe this trip in one phrase, it'd definitely be life-changing, because when I go home, it's not going to be the same anymore.
My world now!
Yeah.
Today we talked about having a vision for our life. You know, it's so important for us to have a God-given vision. The Bible says that where there is no vision, the people perish or the people are unrestrained. You see, when you don't have a vision for your life, you might run in this direction one day and that direction in another. One day I was flying on one of those small commuter jets to a little city that didn't have any air traffic controllers. But there was a lot of bad weather that day, and so we got to the city and we began to circle around and circle around. And eventually the plane just dipped down through the clouds. He looked around, he couldn't find the airport, and he shot back up through those clouds, and it scared us to death. Later on I found out the reason why he did that is because he didn't have any idea where he was. The clouds and the fog was clouding his vision so much so that he had lost the airport completely. You know, we couldn't even land at that airport. We had to go to another airport where they had air traffic controllers. That's how important it is for us to have a vision for our life. If we don't have a vision, we don't know where we're going. Now, the Bible says that what we do with the vision, though, how we make it a part of our life, is that we write it down and we read it and then we run with it. And those are the steps that we need to take to practically implement this vision into our life. So I want to encourage you today, pray, talk to God, say, God, what do you have for my life? What did you create me to do? And then write that vision down, set some timetables, set some goals, and then you will find yourself on the path to achieving God's best for your life. Watching today, maybe you're thinking you want to have a God-given vision for your life. I can tell you the most important vision God has for anyone's life is for them to become born again, for them to make Jesus Christ the Lord of their life. That's why the Bible says that God loved you so much that he sent his son Jesus to die on the cross so that you could be born again. All you have to do is receive this gift. You know, there's nothing that you can do to earn God's love or to even earn salvation. That's why the Bible says it's by grace you are saved through faith. It's a gift from God, not by any kind of work, so that you can't boast. The way that you receive this free gift, the Bible says that we need to confess with our mouth that Jesus is Lord. Believe in our heart God has raised him from the dead, and then we will be saved. So right there, right now, I encourage you, bow your head, confess your sin, ask God to forgive you and to cleanse you of your sin, and to give you eternal life, to be the Lord of your life, and he'll change you right there and right now. If you made that decision, call the number on the bottom of your screen or go to tvonelife.com and let us know that God has changed your life. Well, we hope you enjoyed the free art show. To find out more about us, go to tvonelife.com. You can click on their blogs, you can check out our store, and if you'd like to support this ministry, go to tvonelife.com. Right, guys? Who are you?
We're just waiting on a bus.
Oh.